we're here at Hudson Valley Hospital Center today at the opening of their Farmers Market series. We have farmers from all over the local area selling produce, flowers, plants, honeys, jams, pies, really anything that you would like you can get here today at Hudson Valley Hospital Center. We're going to talk to some of the vendors here today. John Fetterspiel, president of Hudson Valley Hospital Center, and just want to ask you, so what did you buy today? And
just made my first purchases here, Victoria, and I've got some great cheese and these fabulous tomatoes, and I'm going to probably be making several other purchases at many of the other vendors.
So this is wonderful here today. Why did Hudson Valley Hospital Center decide to bring this farmer's market here to the hospital?
You know, the obesity epidemic and its impact on disease, chronic disease, well documented in the media. As a healthcare institution, we felt it was, you know, most important for us to encourage the community to eat healthy vegetables, fruits. We went to local farms, locally sourced as many vendors as possible. Most of these vendors are certified organic, and this is the first of what we hope are going to be many, many future farmers markets and a broader program of encouraging the community to eat healthy and live healthy.
You were very involved in getting these farmers here to the market today. Can you tell me a little bit about some of the farmers that we have here today?
Absolutely. I'm very pleased that we have the folks here from Glenwood, the Glenwood Foundation in Garrison. We went over to the Pine Island section across the Hudson, where there are about 12,000 acres of what they have, the black soil, and the Rogowski farm is here. Of course, we have Panzerellas, we have Hemlock Hill, and so many Hilltop Hanovers here, so many local farms and vendors. The Cornell Master Gardeners are here, and I'm sure you're going to have some time to talk to them today. We have many people coming with samples of leaves and other, you know, some people brought in sections of turf, you know, to be looked at. And so we're really meeting, you know, quite a few demands and requirements today.
That's great. So I understand that the hospital launched its organic garden in April, and you have a table. The hospital has a table here.
Yeah, we've got a great table that we're not selling our produce. Obviously, we do not want to compete with all of our wonderful vendors who came in. But we have produce from our own organic garden that we've been giving to our cancer patients and their families to take home. And hopefully you'll be able to get a few shots of that, because that produce has just been absolutely terrific. And Victoria, you and your staff can take great credit for tending the garden and working with the cancer patients and many other community volunteers.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Okay, thank you. So we have Pincus Farm?
Table.
Oh, okay. Tell me where you're from.
We have a kitchen in Kingston, New York. We live close to Woodstock, but our kitchen is in Kingston. And so we work with local farmers. And I use their produce in all the foods that I make. I have a line of soups, of quiches, vegetable tarts, salsa, bruschetta, pesto, tapenade.
Do you sell these just at the farmers markets, or do you sell these to stores at all?
There's also farm stands, farmers markets in Westchester and along the Hudson, and gourmet stores. Yes, we do. Yeah.
This looks fabulous. So tell me a little bit about some of the spreads that you have here. That looks yummy.
Fresh salsa, fresh bruschetta, a white bean dip, the tapenade, the basil pesto. I can tell you, if you check my labels, everything is very simple. Every single ingredient on the label, people will understand. It's not like a store-bought product. All of this is, without preservatives, without hydrogenated oils, and simple ingredients.
Oh, that's great. So you bake all these quiches yourself. Those look, wow, feta spinach. I like that one.
Feta spinach, cherry tomatoes. It's kind of a Greek twist, on the classical traditional quiche. But I do have some traditional quiches with bacon and cheddar cheese. But then, we try to make it a little bit you know, give people an exciting choice.
Right.
Yes, yeah, like spinach with goat cheese, very mild goat cheese, or a caramelized onion and goat cheese. Yeah.
Oh, great.
Perfect lunches and
soups and everything
soups,
here.
Yeah, soups come like this in 22-ounce containers. Mm-hmm. I also have them in 1 gallon food service bags, but then also great lunches.
Oh, you have them frozen.
Single serving, 10 ounces. It's like a perfect single serving. So very easy.
Oh, that's great. I bet the gazpacho will go really well today since it's so hot outside. Absolutely. Yes. Okay, so you're from Glenwood Farm and Cold Spring, right?
That's right.
So tell me a little bit about your farm and some of the produce. And
Glenwood is located in Cold Spring, New York, right in the middle of Fonstock State Park. We're a 501c3, so we have a working farm where we pasture livestock and we raise vegetables. But we also have a program office, and we get out and help the community in a variety of ways, helping encourage them to support farming.
Great. And so do you do some educational work out there as well, or pretty much just raising awareness about local farmers?
We do some education on the property. We do workshops for the public. Sometimes we offer convenings where we gather and discuss issues affecting farmers in the region. We have an apprentice program, or Sophie here is one of our wonderful apprentices, learning about sustainable agriculture on the farm.
So tell me a little bit about some of the produce. What are you most proud of? I see you have some cheese there. Interested in that.
Yes, the cheese is from a neighboring farm, Sprout Creek. The produce is all grown at Glenwood and is certified naturally grown, which follows all the federal program guidelines, but is a peer-review-based program.
Wow. So is that goat cheese or milk?
Cow's milk cheese.
We grow over 20 varieties of tomatoes. We're pretty proud of that. And they're just starting to come in earnest, so you'll see a lot more next week. But we have a lot of great products here.
That's
and
great.
A lot more to come.
I love these little sun golds. I love those. Those are like really just like candy. They're like delicious. Okay, well, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay, hi. So you're from Continental Organics. Tell me where that is?
Continental Organics, it's up in New Windsor, New York, so across the river in Orange County, and we are an aquaponics facility. So we grow all organic, NOFA certified lettuces, as you see here, and fish, although our fish are still relatively small at this point. So as of right now, we have two large greenhouses, which we use to grow. You have here some arugula, some mixed lettuces, some Swiss chard, and some microgreens here. We also have some thyme here, some other spices of all sorts. And basically, the mission is to have sustainable agriculture at a low price, so lower than most organic, the organic market is right now, and in quantity, so we can actually supply the market what it wants, what it needs.
So tell me a little bit about the hydroponics, aquaponics. I think it's really fascinating. I think most people don't really understand how it works. So these plants are not grown in soil, correct?
Correct, yeah.
Tell me a little bit about that.
Sure, no problem. It's essentially hydroponics. However, the major difference is we actually use fish waste, fish emulsion, as the main fertilizer as opposed to chemical fertilizers. So in a way, that sort of solves an issue of organic, because there really is no technical certification for aquaponic organics right now. We're sort of creating it as we go along.
Right, so the water just doesn't provide the nutrients, so
right.
You use the tilapia
correct.
As a way to fertilize it naturally.
Correct, yeah. So that actually the fish waste is water soluble, of course, and then that water is pumped through the roots of the plants. The plants soak up the nitrates and the other nutrients they desire, and then that water goes back through to the fish. So the root system actually ends up, it takes the nutrients and it filters the water simultaneously. So it's a loop system.
We're Hemlock Farm. We're just up the road off of 202 on Croton Avenue. The farm was established by the DeMarie family in 1938. It's owned currently by John DeMarie. And Laura DeMarie is the operating manager of the farm.
Oh, great.
So we have black Angus, hog, sheep, Peking duck, chicken and hen, rabbit, guinea pig, goat. I'm sure there's probably a couple of them.
Wow, that's really, really eclectic. I don't think people would imagine that you would actually have like livestock so close here. We're right like around the corner and you have all these animals that you're raising. And, you know, tell me why people should buy this rather than, you know, in the butcher shop or over at the grocery store.
All our meat is organically raised. It's fed grain. I like the hog are fed grain from a co-op out of Connecticut. Our beef, which is our pride, the Black Angus, they're fed grain from St. Lawrence Brewing Company, Captain Lawrence Brewing.
Oh.
So they're bred all the Harley and the barley and the hops, mm-hmm. and also grass-fed and free-range, which is pretty much all of our animals.
So this really fascinates me. I want to hear all about this Winter Sun Farm. So tell us a little bit about what you do and how people can have, you know, produce over the winter, which is interesting.
It is great. We take vegetables from local farms in the Hudson Valley. Fruits and vegetables range from blueberries to heirloom tomatoes, butternut squash, broccoli. We take it at the peak of its freshness. We freeze it individually and then distribute it throughout the winter, December through April. So you get local vegetables that taste really great. All you have to do is take them out of the freezer and thaw them, and it's fresh local Hudson Valley vegetables.
Wow, that's great. So how can somebody sign up for this type of thing?
Well, we're here because we are doing a pickup at the hospital this winter, December through April. So if you'd like, you can sign up by going to our website, which is just www.wintersunfarms.com. Or you can come to this farmer's market, which will be going on, and I'll be here for people to sign up.
Okay, that's great. So we'll be here, this farmer's market will be here once a month on the third Tuesday through November, so people can come and find you here. Now, is this delivered to people's homes, or do they pick up? Or
They pick it up, and we'll be here at the hospital once a month where people can come and pick up their share. So it works great. If you work at the hospital, just stop on by and get your vegetables if you live close. It's pretty convenient. So.
Okay, great. Thanks for talking to us.
You're welcome.
Okay, can you tell me a little bit about your farm? Where are you from?
The store itself is on Oregon Road in Cortland Manor, and it's a family-owned farm. It's over on the other side of the river. Most of these items here on this table are from that farm or neighboring farms on the other side of the river.
Oh, great. And what's the name of your farm?
It's the Homestead Nurseries is the store.
Homestead Nurseries. Yep. That's great. So is most of this produce that we have here now local, or are you a combination? Oh, it's... Already.
On these tables here, it's all from either his farms or neighboring farms.
Wow. So tell me a little bit about what you have today.
Boy, we can start all the way on the end. Onions, beets, lettuces, a variety of lettuce, onions, scallions, fresh garlic, which is delicious. Tomatoes are in. Tomatoes, we have about four or five different kinds of tomatoes now. Plums, the blueberries are in. They're probably going to be seeing them go soon. The peaches are delicious. Another item down there, another peach, it's called a donut peach, it's very, very good. And then all the zucchinis and squashes, potatoes, onions, and like I said, they're all from the farms on the other side of the river.
Great. So tell me something I've always wanted to know about squash. We have some in our garden. How large should you let them get? When should you pick these squash?
Small. As you see on the what you want to do, when you want to stuff a big zucchini, you let it grow big. But the farmers and people who normally sell this stuff yell at you for doing that. But it's delicious stuff.
So we have Dave Liddy here. He's from Cornell Cooperative Extension. He is with the Master Gardeners Program. And they're here today at Hudson Valley to give some advice to gardeners. Tell me a little bit about the program and what kinds of things people ask you.
Cornell Cooperative Extension is part of Cornell University. It's a educational program that hopes to promote natural gardening techniques as much as possible. And today we're here to try and answer some questions from local gardeners about problems they're having. We want to hear about successes that they're having and what's working and what isn't.
What are some of the things that people have asked you today so far?
This morning we've had questions about everything from lemon trees not bearing fruit to cucumbers being eaten by critters to what's going on with my mulch pile.
Okay, so that's good to be able to answer those questions. So tell me, my zinnias have a lot of mildew. What can I do about it?
They could be getting too much water. That would be a prime suspect. There could be an organism in the soil. It would be very helpful if we could see one. And we also have our research arm down in Valhalla takes in samples, and they'll put them under the microscope, and they will then give you a real good idea of what's causing the problem.
So when you're not here, how could I get my soil tested or get this done?
We have a website, which we make available to the general public, and we can also pass along I don't know if you can see that. This is our bookmark that has all of the contact information on the back. Give us a call, tell us what the problem is, and we'll arrange to either do the analysis there, or we have a site visit program. We'll send a team of master gardeners to your home, and we'll take a look at what the environment is like now. We'll talk with you and decide how you want to make it better or different, and then we'll send a complete report back a couple of weeks later.
So you're from Hilltop Hanover Farm in Yorktown.
Yes, I am.
And it's a wonderful environmental center. Why don't you tell us a little bit about the center and about some of the produce you have here today from the farm?
Everything here that we have at the farm, we grew. My name is Brad O'Carroll. I'm the head farmer at Hilltop Hanover. We do 120, actually now we have 123 member CSA. We do a farm stand. We do U-pick vegetables on Saturdays. Everything is organically grown, and it is operated by the Friends of Hilltop Hanover Farm, which is a nonprofit organization that has taken over the farm since the county stepped aside, and it's been great. So it's been our second season operating the CSA in the farm stand, and I have to say that everything's been very successful this year.
That's great. So do you still do educational programs
up at
the farm?
We do. We're actually holding a camp right now. We do classes. We also have a relationship with Westchester Community College, where we do sustainability classes. You can also get your sustainability certificate. So we have that with Westchester. We also do canning classes, weekend classes, family classes.
We have Myra Masochi, right?
Masochi
here from Shades of Green, and they actually helped us with the organic garden at Hudson Valley Hospital Center. They're here today. Why don't you tell us a little bit about Shades of Green?
Well, we are a garden design and maintenance company, but we like to grow a lot of our own perennials, shrubs, annuals, and of course vegetables and herbs. We sell at the Peekskill Farmer's Market, and we're happy to join the hospital here in their new farmer's market. I'm really proud of this hospital and what direction they're going with. It was a pleasure to help them design the vegetable garden, and now it's a pleasure to bring our own wonderful herbs and vegetables, all organically grown, to the hospital and help spread the awareness of how good these things are for your health.
And you're located right here in?
Right here in Crompon, which is part of Cortland Manor, so I'm less than 2 miles away. It's an easy commute, and we also are really experienced in what works here and what grows really well for people and give them great advice for it.
Great. I love your green shades. Shades of green. Okay. Have a great day. So we have Tammy here from Wright Farms, one of our local farms, and tell us a little bit about these jams. They're so beautiful.
Aren't they great? Well, one of the reasons we started making these jams and jellies is because my grandmother would actually make them for our family, and we never made them to sell. So one day I said, Grandma, can't you make us some strawberry jam? And so she did, and in like minutes it sold. So we started doing all these different flavors. So the other thing that she used to make for our family were the dilly beans and the bread and butter pickles. So those are the Grandma Ann's signature canned item that she used to make for us. But now we've grown into doing all these other varieties with our fruits and, fruits and some vegetables. And it's just all homemade from our garden, and we transform it into this and bring it to the farmer's market.
Oh, that's great. I love pickled beets. I've definitely got to get some of those before does. I leave today. So, and then the rest of it, you have your produce here, I see.
Everything is grown on our farm. We're mostly fruit growers, but we do dabble in a little vegetables like zucchini and string beans and pumpkins and winter squash. Tomatoes we'll have soon also. These we have some little tomatoes right now. So yeah, we're kind of like into it pretty deep.
Great. And where are you located exactly?
We're in Gardner. It's right outside of New Paltz. And we also do pick your own apples in the fall.
Great. That smells like really, really good. And it's making me very hungry. So you're from Panzarella?
I am Panzarella.
You are Panzarella. Oh, well, that's good. So tell me a little bit about, this is quite a mix here. You have breads, you have food. Tell me what you have here today.
My partner and I have a bakery in Hackensack. It's a central bakery. Today we have a variety of bread, but we're always at the Peekskill Farmer's Market every Saturday with maybe a little bit more sampling. With all the baguettes, all the Pullmans, they're all artisan. They're all made 100% by hand. Most of what you see today, because we do a lot of green markets, are made with New York-grown flour. And we have some nice 100% whole wheat, seven-grain bowls and baguettes. Some of our baguettes have a raisin and walnut and a little bit of cinnamon. We have a nice new loaf on the other side with 100% whole wheat and cranberry, walnut, and chocolate.
Wow.
And that's a fabulous one. Our pizzas are 100% whole wheat, artisan made, nice thin crust.
Wow.
So I do a variety of nice European and Italian breads.
So tell me about these crab cakes. They're so yummy. Are you selling these?
Yeah, we're sampling them and selling them. The crab cakes and our fresh mozzarella are probably our number one items. We started the crab cakes about 10 years ago. We use all Maryland lump crab. We shred it. We blend it throughout. And one thing we do a little bit different than everyone is we don't fill it with any green peppers or any red peppers, so there's not a lot of fillers.
The crab. Yeah.
The outside is done with a light breading on the outside only. And we actually advertise the champagne. We actually do use a little bit of sweet champagne in the recipe, and that seems to tone down the horseradish a little. So it's a nice recipe.
So what do you use to hold it together? Is it?
We use just a touch of mayonnaise. Just a touch of fresh mayonnaise.
Okay, so no breadcrumbs or anything.
Just
like
on
that.
The outside.
Just on the,
only
on
the outside.
Crisp on the
just
outside.
A crisp. That's it.
Great. Hi, I have a Jackie here from Rogowski Farm and Pine Island. That's right on your T-shirt, so it makes it easy. So this is great. This is beautiful here today. I see you have flowers. I love flowers.
Oh, yeah.
Tell me a little bit about what you have here today at the market.
Well, we have a selection from our farm. We're a certified naturally grown farm, so we don't use any chemicals or pesticides. So we have a little bit of amaranth, which is almost like a red spinach. We have beets, carrots, four different types of potatoes, so whether you want purple potatoes, red potatoes, white potatoes, or fingerlings, we have it. We have flowers that we planted with some wildflowers. We also have our line of Black Dirt Gourmet products, which is a mix of prepared foods made from the leftover vegetables we bring back from our market. So that way nothing goes to waste. So we have sweet potato salads, we have roasted vegetable wraps, gazpacho, fresh squeezed lemonade. We have some local honey from our farm, fresh from our own beehives.
Right. Well, I got to get some of that gazpacho. Our hospital president was having some before. It's green gazpacho, he was saying. Is it green gazpacho?
It is. It's with like cucumbers and peppers and all sorts of stuff. It's really good.
Sounds really good. So you'll be here for the other farmers markets that we're having, correct?
Yeah.
You're going to be great.
You will.
All right. Thanks very much.
You're welcome.
Thank you for joining us today on Health Smart. I hope you enjoyed the show and some of the vendors that we spoke with. And if you need more information, you can visit the hospital website at www.hvhc.org. And good night.